Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Brief History of the Empire, Part 4, which I bought right here in Dr. Andy Weir's gear store in Cambria, which is in Cambria. A Brief History of the Empire, Part 4. The first book of this series described in brief the first eight emperors of the Septim Dynasty, beginning with Tiber I. The second volume described the War of the Red Diamond and the six emperors who followed. The third volume describes the troubles of the next three emperors, the frustrated Uriel IV, the ineffectual Sepphoris II, and the heroic Uriel V. At Uriel V's death across the sea in distant, hostile Akavir, Uriel VI was but 5 years old. In fact, Uriel VI was born only shortly before his father left for Akavir. Uriel V's only other progeny, by a different woman, were the twins Morahatha and Eloisa, who had been born a month after Uriel V left. Uriel VI was coronated in the 290th year of the Third Era. The consort Thonica, as the boy's mother, was given a restricted regency until Uriel VI reached his minority. The council retained the real power, as they had ever since the days of Kataraya I. The council so enjoyed its unlimited and unrestricted freedom to make laws and profits, Uriel VI was not given full license to rule until 307, when he was 22 years old. He had been slowly assuming positions of responsibility for years, but both the council and his mother, who enjoyed even her limited regency, were loath to give him reign. By the time he came to the throne, the mechanisms of government gave him little power but the power to veto. This power he regularly exercised. By 313, Uriel VI could boast with conviction that he truly did rule Tamriel. He utilized defunct spy networks and guard units to bully and coerce the difficult members of the Elder Council. His sister was his usual ally, after her marriage to Baron Ulf Gerson of Winterhold brought her considerable wealth and influence. As the sage Uggeridge said, Uriel V conquered Esronier, but Uriel VI conquered the Elder Council. When Uriel VI fell from his horse and could not be saved by the finest imperial healers, his beloved sister Morahatha took the throne. At 25 years of age, she had been described by admittedly self-serving diplomats as the most beautiful creature in Tamriel. She was certainly well-learned, vivacious, athletic, and a well-practiced politician. She brought the Archmagister of Skyrim to the Imperial City and created the second Imperial Battle Mage since the days of Tiber Septim. Morahatha finished the job her brother had begun and made the Imperial Province truly a government under the Empress. Outside the Imperial Province, however, the Empire had been slowly disintegrating. Open revolutions and civil wars had raged unchallenged since the days of her grandfather Sepphoris II. Carefully coordinating her counterattacks, Morahatha slowly took back her rebellious vassals, always avoiding overextending herself. Though Morahatha's military campaigns were remarkably successful, the council was often frustrated by her deliberate pace. One councilman, an Argonian named Thoracles Romus, furious at her refusal to send troops to his troubled lands, is believed to be the man who hired the assassins who claimed her life in Third Era 339. Romus was tried and executed, though he protested his innocence. Morahatha had no surviving children, and Eloisa had died of a fever 4 years before. Eloisa's 25-year-old son Pelagius was crowned Pelagius IV. Pelagius IV continued his aunt's work, slowly bringing back the seditious kingdoms of the Empire. He had Morahatha's patience and deliberate pace in his endeavors, but alas, he did not have her success. The kingdoms had been free of constraints for so long, even a benign imperial presence was odious. Nevertheless, when Pelagius died, after an astonishing 49-year reign, Tamriel was closer to unity than it had been since the days of Uriel I. Our current emperor, The awesome and terrible majesty, Uriel Septim VII, son of Pelagius IV, has the diligence of his great aunt Marahatha, the political skill of his great uncle Uriel VI, and the military prowess of his great grand uncle Uriel V. For 21 years he reigned and brought justice and order to Tamriel. In the year Third Era, 389, his imperial battle mage Jagar Tharn betrayed him. Uriel VII was imprisoned in a dimension of Tharn's creation, and Tharn used his magic of illusion to assume the Emperor's aspect. For the next 10 years, Tharn used imperial privileges, but did not continue Uriel VII's schedule of reconquest. It is not entirely known yet what Tharn's goals and personal accomplishments were during the 10 years he imitated his liege lord. In Third Era, 399, a mysterious champion defeated the battle mage in the dungeons of the Imperial Palace and freed Uriel VII from his other dimensional cell. Since his release, Uriel VII has worked diligently to renew the battle to reunite Tamriel. Tharn's interference broke the momentum, but the years since then have proven that the glorious golden age of Tiber Septim may be visited on Tamriel once again. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Brief History of the Empire, Part 4.